Tram 21 lines up and John Reynolds, the lone Englishman, with a trio of marauding Scots. And Steve Hislop on pole position. Troy Bayliss, Matt Llewellyn, Michael Rutter, and second in the championship, Chris Walker, fastest on row two. Sean Emmett, James Hayden, Terry Reimer, and Ian Simpson back from injury with that recently damaged right arm. Max Vincent, the quickest of the privateers, and championship leader Phil Giles alongside him. Drama already. At the end of the warm-up lap, Troy Bayliss has not taken up his place on the second row. And what a cracking start, making amends for Matt Llewellyn, who rockets through into the lead on the number 43 yellow GSE Ducati. Llewellyn leads. He's doing the job all on his own. Bayliss pulled in at the end of the warm-up lap. His practice crash yesterday, obviously, Roger, proving too much for him.
It was a terrible crash that he had. It was at this corner that we're at now on the circuit, Graham Hill Bend. He exited just there, lost the front end and went down and damaged his right hand, which of course is his throttle and front brake hand. But his teammate's doing a sterling job at the moment. Matt Llewellyn, he's leading.
This is home ground for the GSE Ducati squad. Daryl Healy, the team boss, has 200 corporate guests on the exit of Clearways watching the action, and Matt Llewellyn doing a great job for them as through into the lead goes John Reynolds, number four, on the rival Reve Red Racing Ducati. Look at him go. John Reynolds, number four, leads. Llewellyn in second, so Ducati first, Ducati second. Pole position man Steve Hislop, Ian McPherson continuing this renaissance to form. He's going well, McPherson, fighting to keep his place, certainly if not in the Kawasaki squad with some team for the 1999 season. Right with them goes James Hayden, number eight, on the Suzuki. Sean Emmett as well as they come down towards Clearways. Emmett, number five, on the red Ducati, right there behind Hayden. It's Hislop in third, Llewellyn in second. Way, way, way down the order, reigning champion Neil McKenzie at this moment in time. And Chris Walker not performing terribly well. Early in the race, Walker is in seventh place. McKenzie, championship leader, is in tenth. And he has a clear job to do because coming here to Brands Hatch, McKenzie led Walker by 57 points. He must at the very least keep Chris Walker in his sights because Neil McKenzie has a real chance of wrapping up the title here at Brands Hatch with two races remaining at Donington Park.
Well, I think that the most outstanding thing on the track at the moment is Steve Hislop. Let's not forget he was in pole position. He's had a two-race break. He dislocated his wrist very badly and broke some bones in his feet at Cadwell Park. There he is on bike number 11, challenging now for second place from Matt Llewellyn. And Hislop riding exceptionally well. Hislop's got a point to prove, don't forget. He's returning from an injury and he wants to prove that he hasn't lost any of that zest to win or the ability to beat Neil McKenzie.
He also trails Chris Walker. It's the number 11 Yamaha we're talking about, by 34 points. And Hislop could easily grab second in the championship if he continues this form. He's been working hard on that right wrist, or rather the physiotherapist has been working hard on that right wrist to give him the strength he needs, and most importantly, to enable him to have the movement to blip the throttle as he changes down through the gearbox. Number 11, Steve Hislop, was saying that in the first practice on Friday, he was having to clunk it down through the gearbox simply because he couldn't even twist the throttle with his right hand. So this is an immense show of strength and a huge amount. Oh, 10-second jumpstart penalty. Who's that? Two riders. Number 5, Sean Emmett. Number 22, Ian Simpson. So Emmett, despite the fact he's running out there strongly, and of course he will not know that he's incurred that 10-second penalty, so he will keep on riding as hard as he can, and he's going to forfeit 10 seconds. Look at Hayden, number 8, on the Suzuki. James Hayden, still suffering with that shoulder injury in the wheel tracks of Steve Hislop.
Well, Sean Emmett got a jump start there. There's James Hayden on bike 8 and Sean Emmett on bike 5. He's at the back of the pitch and now on the tail end of this group coming into Hawthorne Bend. Sean Emmett's not going to be too happy about that jump start, but the officials have got to be keen. The rules state that the front wheel may move, but the back axle can't cross the start line. If that happens, you incur the 10-second penalty, and they're pretty keen on that.
Sean Emmett's back axle has gone past James Hayden. He now leads the number 8 Suzuki. So number 5, Sean Emmett, now in hot pursuit of this man, Steve Hislop, who's in third. Ahead of Hislop, Matt Llewellyn, going very, very well indeed on the GSE Ducati, the lone Ducati. Remember, Troy Bayliss came out of the race after the warm-up lap and that is a great disappointment for everyone here, not least of all, of course, Bayliss himself. Hislop, now under real pressure. Number 5, Emmett. He's a wizard round here at Brands. He lives in Surrey. He does a lot of his practice down here, and he won here on a slick tyre in the rain, and I still marvel at that feat. No less. Oh, look on the inside of Druids. Emmett gone past Hislop. Up to third place then. Sean Emmett. Ducati in third. Ducati in second. Ducati leads. It's a red benefit with a yellow one in the middle. Wow, who's that? Somebody on the gravel. Bike end over end. That's one of the privateers. That's Nigel Nottingham on the Yamaha. Or rather off the Yamaha. The rear seat section having come detached. Yeah, Nottingham it is. Being held to safety by the marshals. A lot of runoff area here. There's McKenzie. McKenzie now in ninth place behind the number 3 Honda of Michael Rutter.
Well, Neil McKenzie's certainly got a lot of work to do, but he's on one of his favourite circuits, Brands Hatch Grand Prix circuit. He's done the World Superbike round here earlier in the year, and let's not forget that Chris Walker hasn't, so that could give McKenzie an advantage.
Look at Sean Emmett in third. Oh, on the inside of Matt Llewellyn. Sean Emmett goes up to second place, but I remind you, second on the road. He has got a 10-second penalty, and 0.3 seconds separated the top 6 in qualifying, so that'll give you some idea of just how far down the field Sean Emmett will be at the finish, despite the fact he is riding like a Trojan. Ben Atkins, the manager of the Rebbe Racing team, will be... Oh, somebody went off in a big way! In the background there, somebody went off in a big way, one of the front runners. Don't know who that is, but it was a big, big crash. Meanwhile, number 4, Reynolds leads from teammate Sean Emmett. Hislop in third. It's Hayden. It's James Hayden being assisted over the tyre wall to safety. Looking a bit second-hand, Roger, but that was a fast one.
It certainly was. That would be Graham Hill Bend, 120 miles an hour there. James, I wouldn't say he's used to crashing, but he does take knocks pretty well. He's young, he's 24 years old, but that will certainly have knocked the wind out of him.
He's still nursing that shoulder injury as well. Look at the battle between these two as Emmett goes through into the lead of Paddock Hill Bend. Steve Hislop had a good look at the inside as well. John Reynolds now tucking back as they come up to Druids. It's the 27-year-old Sean Emmett leading the 33-year-old Reynolds, his teammate. And what a pair these are now, back to full fitness. Reynolds, you remember, nursing that injured right heel for the best part of this season, but he's back with a bang. Sean Emmett, similarly, through up into second place, goes this up. No, he doesn't. Reynolds denies him the opportunity, closes him down, and they're still running strongly. The Red Ducati is 1-2 in this race, with Steve Hislop, the pole position man, unbelievably close, grabbing second place. This is one breathtaking race.
Well, John Reynolds got a fantastic drive out of Surtees Bend because both him and Hislop have passed Sean Emmett. Hislop wasn't sure if his wrist was going to do the distance or not, but it looks like it's holding up pretty well to me.
Steve Hislop came here 34 points adrift of second place Chris Walker on the Kawasaki in the championship. He's looking for second. He knows he can't win it now. That honour almost certainly will go to Neil McKenzie, who is still much, much further down the order. Look at these three. You could put a tent over them. They're so close. As they drop down into clearways, the right-hander onto the start-finish straight again. Hislop in second. It is Sean Emmett in third. John Reynolds, there's David Heal, retiring the V-twin Honda. It's not been a happy year for that particular bike. And, oh, it's all going on a pattern. Look at Chris Walker, number 2, on the inside of Matt Llewellyn, number 43, and McKenzie. Now, McKenzie, the wily old fox, knows that all he has to do is stay with Chris Walker, and he's doing exactly that at Druids, up the inside of the yellow Ducati. So Llewellyn down another place, but it's no disgrace to be passed by Neil McKenzie. He is very, very quick round here, doing just what he has to do and no more. He knows full well that if he hangs onto the back of the number 2 Kawasaki of Chris Walker, then this championship, Roger, is as good as his.
Well, Neil McKenzie's priority is to win the championship, and the team's priority is to win the championship. But as regards to team orders, that man there in the picture, Steve Hislop, he's thrown all of that out of the window because he's ahead of McKenzie in the race.
Well, what McKenzie's trying to do, of course, is make sure that Chris Walker doesn't get more than a 7-point advantage on him, because he came here with 57 points. There are still 50 points up for grabs at the final two races at Donington Park. And Hislop, of course, in doing what he's doing, will in fact take points off his teammate Neil McKenzie. But he's so far ahead that, frankly, there's not much more he can do. He can only go for second and maybe even get a shot at the win. He's certainly quick enough. Reynolds, though, leading. 4 machine lengths as they come out of clearways. Onto the start-finish straight. Hislop with his head down, and around they go again. Can Steve Hislop pull something out of the bag this time? In third place, number 5, Sean Emmett, but he has a 10-second penalty, so you can effectively discount him. That means Chris Walker, this man, with Neil McKenzie right in his slipstream. McKenzie is so close he almost ran into the back of Chris Walker at Druids. Matt Llewellyn still going on very, very strongly there, but this is the battle for the lead. Hislop on the inside of Reynolds, but is Reynolds going to hold it? Yes, he does. Away they go again, out into the country at the back. Tailenders ahead of them. John Reynolds number 4 leads. Hislop is so determined, he is unbelievable. Into the lead goes Steve Hislop. A last lap, breathtaking move as they come down towards Westfields with tailenders. And frankly, Roger, I don't think it's going to make much difference. It looks like the Yamaha victory.
Hislop was so aggressive then, I think the front wheel of his bike touched John Reynolds' knee, but it's all going to be about Steve Hislop winning now by the look of it, through Dingle Dell. Two opportunities to overtake, this one at Stirling's Bend, and John Reynolds can't make it as Steve Hislop sides his way past the tail enders. Just one corner left, and that's Clearways.
Under the bridge, Clearways, the right-hander ahead of them, and it's Hislop. Reynolds has followed him through the traffic. My goodness me, they were going so much quicker than the tail-enders. Look at Hislop, his head is down, his tail is up. The right knee tucked back in for maximum drive. Oh yes, Steve Hislop wins round 21 here at Brands, chased all the way by John Reynolds. A terrific result for Hislop. What a comeback. Two races out, and here he is with a win. First to congratulate him, Reynolds, but look at that. Chris Walker got the better of McKenzie, but the wily old McKenzie knew exactly what he was doing. Matt Llewellyn got fifth. That was a good ride. Sean Emmett's 10-second penalty dropped him to eighth.
Oh, and safety's... I tend to square it off a bit, and I'd lined it up a lot before. We actually had a little bit of coming together, but it wasn't intended, really. But and then John got the drive out the corner, so I got him at the end of the back straight on the brakes and just held him off. So.
Everything went according to plan.
Dream come true. Honestly.
Well done.
Peter Graves took the privateer win on home soil. Max Vincent clawed back 4 points on championship leader Phil Giles. The gap between Vincent and Giles now 17 points, so Vincent has a real chance of lifting the privateer title. Steve Hislop has a real chance of grabbing second in the title from Chris Walker. He's delighted. In the championship proper, the chances of Hislop catching Walker are much more likely than Walker catching McKenzie. With 3 races still to go, 75 points up for grabs. The title is all but done for McKenzie. Reynolds has leapfrogged into 5th place and has a real chance of grabbing 4th.